Welcome to Analog Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain signal-to-noise ratio of amplitude modulated signal at receiver side, and I'll explain you what are the effects that is there of noise on conventional AM. So let us begin this session with first of all, what is AM signal? So I have already explained AM signal, so modulated AM signal, if you see modulated AM signal, then that modulated AM signal will be, if I say it is U of t, then that will be AC cos of omega CT plus MT into cos of omega CT, where MT, that is what modulating signal, and U of t, that is what conventional AM modulated signal. Now let us rewrite this in simplified form. So if I take AC cos omega CT common out of it, then you will be finding it is 1 plus MT by AC into cos of omega CT. Now as we know, AM by AC, where AM is amplitude of modulated signal and AC, that is carrier amplitude, then AM by AC is modulating index, then I can rewrite this equation in terms of 1 plus mu, and now this MT, now that will be normalized one, so MN of T into cos of omega CT, and where we can say where mu is equals to AM by AC, that is modulating index. So this is what conventional AM signal that we have. Now first I'll explain you what happens in coherent detection. So in coherent detection of AM, you will be receiving signal. Let us say that signal is RT, and then all we do is we multiply that with carrier signal CT, and that carrier signal is cos omega CT. Then you have output, and that is what we pass it through low pass filter, and then we receive actual signal. So if I say here my signal is y of t, and here if I say my signal is y dash of t, then we will be identifying what is our signal to noise ratio at y dash t signal. So before that, we need to calculate what is y of t. Now see, when you receive signal which is r of t, so that will be practically this modulated signal at transmitter side, and plus noise that will get added due to channel. So this r of t, that will be modulating signal plus it will be noise signal, let us say it is nt. So ultimately rt, that will be received signal, which will be noise signal plus transmitted signal. So that is what RT, that is UT plus NT. So we can say, received signal. If you want to calculate it, then that received signal will be RT is equals to UT plus noise signal NT. Now we already know what is transmitted signal, that is this. So let me write it first. So that is AC into 1 plus mu MN of T into cos of omega CT plus noise signal. So noise signal, that we can represent in two components. One is NCT, that is NCT cos omega CT minus NST sin omega CT. And this is what we can represent it for additive wise Gaussian noise. So this is what the case which is there with AWGN noise. Now let us re-simplify this. So here you can see this is having cos component and this is having cos component. So we can take cos component common out of it. So you'll be receiving AC into 1 plus mu MNT plus NCT into cos omega CT minus NST sin omega CT. So this is what the case which we receive. Now see, in coherent detection our output YT, that is what product modulation of carrier signal into received signal. So Y of T, that will be multiplication of R of T into C of T. R of T is this and C of T is cos omega CT. So Y of T will be, so from this we can say Y of T, that is R of T into C of T, and R of T is this. So that is AC into 1 plus mu MNT plus NCT into C of T is cos omega CT. If I directly write, then this will be cos square of omega CT minus NST sin omega CT cos omega CT. Now see here this cos square omega CT. So cos square omega CT, that is actually 1 plus, that is actually 1 plus cos 2 t that is 1 plus cos 2 omega CT by 2. And as we know, this sin omega CT cos omega CT, so 2 sin omega CT cos omega CT, that is actually sin 2 omega CT. So if we use this two trigonometric formula over here, then we can simplify this equation further. So let us simplify this. So you will be finding there are two components for this case, cos square omega CT. One component will be half of AC into 1 plus mu MNT plus NCT. So this is one component, that is half. And second component will be plus half of AC into 1 plus mu MNT plus NCT into cos 2 omega CT. So this is what this two term that is there with cos square omega CT. And see, this is what 2 sin cos is equals to sin 2 theta. So if I simplify this in this way, so in that case it will become minus NST by 2 into sin 2 omega CT. So that is how it is there. Now see, as I have told you, in coherent detection, once you have product modulation, that is YT, you just pass it through low pass filter. So when you pass it through low pass filter, high frequency components will get eliminated. So high frequency components that will get eliminated after passing this signal through low pass filter. So if I pass this YT through low pass filter, so after low pass filter, high frequency component will get eliminated. So what is that which is getting eliminated? So you can see this is what cos 2 omega CT, so that is high frequency component, and this is sin 2 omega CT, that is high frequency component. So this term and this term, that will get eliminated. So see, now I have given new name, that is Y dash T. So now Y dash T will be half of AC into 1 plus mu MNT plus NCT. So that is what my YDST. Let us separate this. Now see, before we separate it, if I pass this through capacitor, then we can remove DC component. So this capacitor that we are using it to remove DC component. So if I use this capacitor, then you will be having Y double dash T. So after capacitor, we remove DC component. So what are those DC component here? So you can see this is what DC component, AC by 2. So that is what we are going to remove about. So your Y double dash T, so you can see it is half of mu AC MNT plus half of NCT. So that is what the signal which we receive here. Now from this we can clearly say this component that is having signal power and this component that is having noise power, and by taking signal power to noise power we can have SNR of signal. So as if we want to calculate signal power, so let us say signal power is S. So signal power will be first of all this half and square of this components. So it will be mu square AC square and power of MNT. So that will be PMN by 2. So practically this will be 1 by 4 mu square AC square PMN. Now when we talk about noise power, so noise power that will be this half into noise signals power. So let us say it is PN. Now see, for additive wise Gaussian noise, for additive white Gaussian noise, we can calculate noise power by integration. And see, this NCT is there, so this has to be PN by 2. And bandwidth that is there with 2B for AM signal, so you can say it is varying from minus 2B to plus 2B eta by 2 into DF. And this is what we do it for additive Y Gaussian noise. So this has to be 4. So 4. AWGN, additive white Gaussian noise, that is how it is been calculated. So if you do this integration, you will be finding this eta b that eta by 2 that will come outside, and integration of 1 that will be f, and if you apply limits it will be 4b. So 4b divided by 8, so it will be 1 by 2 of eta b, where b is bandwidth. So that is how we have noise. So now based on this we have signal power and noise power. So as we have signal power and noise power, by taking a ratio we can have signal to noise ratio. So SNR, that is signal power, that is 1 by 4 mu square AC square PMN divided by noise power, that is half eta bandwidth B. So if you further simplify this, you will be finding it is half mu square AC square PMN divided by eta B. So that is how we can have this. Now see here, if you see the signal which we have received, so that signal is this. So what will be received power? So let us calculate that received power from this. So received power, that will be PR, and from this equation we can say this received power will be AC square by 2 into 1 plus mu square Pmn. So this is what received power that we can say. Right. Now if I want this signal to noise ratio in terms of baseband signal to noise ratio, then first of all we should know what is signal to noise ratio in terms of baseband signal. So signal to noise ratio SNR of baseband signal system. So that is SNR, let us write it is B. So that SNR of baseband system, that is PR by eta B. Now if I want this SNR in terms of the signal to noise ratio in terms of baseband system, then all I need to do is I need to multiply PR and divide PR. So if I multiply and divide PR, then see PR by eta B, so that is one term, and now divide PR, so half of mu square AC square PMN divided by received power is this, so that is half of 1 plus mu square AC square PMN. So this half will get cancelled and we can say it is, this is what signal to noise ratio of baseband, so it will be SNR of baseband system into mu square AC square PMN divided by 1 plus mu square AC square PMN. Now see, if I say this is constant, if I say this is constant, then this constant into SNR of baseband system. This constant into SNR of this baseband system. Now, here, if you see this constant, then this constant value, that will be always in between 0 to 1. Why? The reason is mu square AC square PMN divided by 1 plus mu square AC square PMN. So, if this mu square AC square PMN, that is lowest, if it is 0, then 0 by 1 plus 0, that is 0. And if this is highest, in that case, highest divided by 1 plus highest, that is 1. So you will be finding this constant value that is there in between 0 to 1. So let me write it on another page and then again I will explain that. So as we have derived this equation, signal to noise ratio, and that is constant C into signal to noise ratio of baseband system, where C is mu square AC square PMN divided by 1 plus mu square AC square PMN. So if you see the range of C, then that range of C, that will be always there in between 0 to 1. Why? The reason is denominator is greater than numerator. So lowest is 0 and highest is 1. So C value is in between 0 to 1. So what it means? It means signal to noise ratio of AM signal, that is always lower than baseband system. So signal to noise ratio, we can say SNR of conventional AM is always less than SNR of baseband system. So that is what we can conclude out of it. Now, as if I want to calculate SNR of envelope detection, then for SNR of envelope detection, so let us have it SNR of traditional AM for envelope detection. So for that, first of all, we need to see what is happening here. So if you see the basic thing of envelope detection, we receive RT we pass it through envelope and we have YT. Now we can use capacitor here to remove DC component and we will be having YST. So this capacitor used to remove DC component. Now as we have derived earlier, what is RT? So that is this, right? Now I'll write it directly again. So received signal RT, so that is AC into 1 plus MT, sorry, mu MT plus NCT cos omega CT minus NST sin omega CT. Now I can rewrite this equation in this term. Let us say it is ET into cos of omega CT plus phi. So what is ET and what is phi? You can see this is cos component and this is sine component. So from that we can say this phi, that is tan inverse of, that is tan inverse of this component divided by this component. So this is minus NST and this is AC into 1 plus mu MT plus NCT. So this is what phi, and what is E of T? So E of T, that has to be square root of cos component square plus sine component square. So that has to be AC 1 plus mu MT plus NCT this square plus NST square. Now here if I consider component, if noise component is very smaller than this signal component. See here, this is having signal. This is having pure noise. So if signal is stronger than pure noise, then we can say this component will get eliminated. So square of this and under root of square of that will get cancelled. So you'll be finding that ET, that will changes to, now square will get cancelled, so it will be AC into 1 plus mu MT plus NCT. So that is what E of T which we will be receiving. And based on that we can say what is YST. So once you pass it through capacitor, you will be removing DC component. And if you do it so after removing DC component by capacitor, you can say your YST output, so that will be AC mu MT plus NCT. So that is what our received signal, and in that this is having signal and this is having noise. Now if you see our coherent detection, so in that same equation is there, right? In that same equation is there, you can see only half is there. So this is what the difference, only half is there, here half is not there, and in coherent detection there is half. So we can say when you calculate SNR, so in SNR signal to noise ratio there is no half, so it will be as similar as this. It will be as similar as this. You will be finding half half in numerator and denominator is available here. In this case it is getting cancelled as half half is not there. So signal to noise ratio will be same as C into this as we receive here. If you calculate this, you will be finding that only, right? I am not calculating, the reason is things are same here. So we can say for envelope detection, signal to noise ratio is same as coherent detection, provided we have higher SNR at transmitter. So SNR at envelope detection is same as SNR in coherent detection, provided SNR at transmitter is high. So this is what we can conclude. But see, if SNR at transmitter is not high, in that case envelope detection will have lower SNR. So this is even one should know. If SNR at transmitter is not that high, then envelope detector has higher noise. So this is what one should understand, and this is what all about signal to noise ratio of traditional AM for coherent detection as well as for envelope detection. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll place videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.